A lot's happened since the last time we were here. It's been a couple months. It's 1994 now, and one of the big things happening in California was the earthquake. A lot of us were woken up about, what, 4:31? Was it January 17th, I believe? And normally when an earthquake hits, I'm the first one out the door, but during this earthquake, I was butt naked. I'm afraid of dying in an earthquake. Everybody else is afraid of dying in an earthquake. But my biggest fear was being naked, running down the streets and having CNN taking shots of it with my boys hanging out. And I know for a fact, shut up. And I would probably die then if that happened. But the earthquake is, if there's anything good about the earthquake is the fact that it brings people together. You know, people have a tendency to actually, you know, get together when there's catastrophes and things hit, and it kind of shows everybody what's really important. Everybody's, concerned about money nowadays, especially in the 90s. You know, the economy's going real bad, but we're hoping that it gets better, but everybody's concerned about money. Prime example is, do we have any basketball fans in the crowd tonight? Basketball fans? Michael Jordan, the basketball player, is now going to try out. I guess he actually got a tryout with the Chicago White Sox. Is that right? Minor league contract with the Chicago White Sox. How much money does this guy need? How much money does Michael Jordan need? I'm sorry. That was a Freudian slip. Michael Jordan plays basketball, doesn't he? And he was real worried because he found out that I guess the sponsorship to the Louisville Slugger batting company went to Tanya Harding. So he was real concerned about that. Don't give me any sympathy claps, please. Now, we're talking about Michael Jackson, and we'll never know if Michael did it or not, because his trial was thrown out. He got off. Oh, I shouldn't say got off, huh?
He did that, too.
I know. That's a bad choice of words. But it's really wild that in America, it actually would have looked better for him if he had been with, like, 16-year-old girls as opposed to 13-year-old boys. So in America, it's okay to be a pedophile as long as you're not a homosexual pedophile. So it's kind of twisted that way. I'm sorry. Let's talk about LaToya Jackson. Ah, hell with LaToya Jackson. LaToya Jackson, it's pretty wild to think you're the weirdest one in that Jackson family. I mean, Michael's awful close, but I think LaToya takes the cake. She is really something else. Roseanne and Arnold, Roseanne and Tom. We have a good show planned for you today on Marty's Corner. Like I said, it's a 94 edition, and they renewed my contract, so I'm now making twice as much as I made before.
So you're making nothing now?
Double nothing. Double nothing.
We all are.
I know. I'll give you a raise. But we have a good show for you tonight. Please stay with us. We have some incredible guests for you tonight. We have a gentleman who's a funny guy and a great impressionist. Alex Pages is here. Alex Pages is here tonight. We have a magician who's going to be making his Marty Shields debut here on Marty's Corner. Bill Perron is here tonight. Bill Perron will be here doing tricks and magic and sleight of hands and fingers coming off. And a great singer. She's also going to be making her first appearance here on the corner. Tamara Wells will be singing a couple of songs for us. Tamara Wells. Like I said, we're live. If you're watching us, you're watching us live. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Take a pee break. Get a soda. Guys, get us out of here. Talk show history, the corner band.
Thank you, Marty. Give me that $5. We're back here on Marty's Corner, and like I said, we hope you give us a call, 333-2427. And how are you doing today, Loree?
Great. Good to be back.
Now, how the earthquake affect you? I mean, were you shaking and rolling?
Yeah, it scared the heck out of us.
Did you get out of the house, or were you actually...
No, didn't get out. We live in a tri-level condominium, so there's stairs forever and ever and ever, so...
You fell all your way down.
I got my son out of bed, though, and yanked him in the driveway.
I didn't get that far because I was looking for a robe or something, so...
Thank you, Marty.
I feel like a bad parent. I'll probably be on hard copy or something. We're going to go ahead and go to something that we do here every time on Marty's Corner. That's the top nine list. The top nine list on Marty's Corner, which is compiled by our home office in Baldwin Park, California. Baldwin Park?
Yeah!
The first time we actually got some applause for Baldwin Park on this show. And like I said, the Olympics are coming up tomorrow Lillehammer, Norway. And what's happening now is the people are becoming more important in the Olympics now with Tanya Harding and all that. And what we've done for this segment is the top nine Olympic problems for Tanya Harding. Top nine Olympic problems for Tanya Harding.
Leave her alone.
I know, somebody should. Number nine is fierce trial judge is an ex-Soviet skating judge. Sorry. God. Rough crowd. Number eight, it's hard to climb into the Olympic podium wearing leg irons.
Wow.
Progressing up. Number seven is she's given a 5-minute slashing penalty during her long program. Anybody get that? Number six on the list, her roommate Big Bertha is the Kerrigan Fan Club president.
Yeah.
God, that's bad. Number five on the list is Brian Botano is cuter than Tanya Harding.
Who's Brian Botano?
He's a skater. Do you know Brian Botano is? You lost the joke. Number four on our list is men's hockey players are frightened of her. She is a scary woman. I'm sorry. I try to give everybody the benefit of the doubt, but not Tanya. Number three on our list is keeps dropping lead pipe during compulsories.
Hey, is that number one?
No, that's number three. Number two on our list. Number two is the Ukrainian skaters keep making cracks about her thighs.
Cracks
about her thighs. Two, three, four, boom. And the number one Olympic problem for Tanya Harding, she lost the endorsement for the club.
I like that last
one. How do you like it,
Idiot. Well, Marty, they're getting better.
Are they? Marginally. At this time, we'd like to bring out someone who's, again, also making his debut here on Marty's Corner. He plays a lot of shows down in Orange County in that area, and he's a real funny guy. Could you please give a warm welcome to Mr. Alex Pages? Alex, come on.
I know you guys are looking at me, and I'm used to it. Because of the fact that he's my father, the fact that why I resemble Elvis Presley.
A bit.
But like, I'm not mad or anything. What I decided to do is I started a support group. You may have heard of it. It's called EPIC, Elvis Presley's Illegitimate Children. We're 2,000 strong and growing every day. Actually, when people look at me, they start playing this mental game of guess my nationality. They look at me and they go, God, is he Mexican? He looks Hawaiian. Filipino? Actually, I'm from Ecuador, you know, but I speak Spanish. It's not the big thing. But what bothers me is like when people just automatically assume that I don't speak any English. For instance, I was in this restaurant the other day. Okay, it was a fast food. All right, it was Taco Bell. The kid behind the counter looked at me and he goes, that'll be $2.65. Do you understand?
I'm like,
yeah, what, are you retarded or something? Well, right then the manager walks over and goes, actually, we do hire the mentally handicapped. I'm like, hey, look, kid, I'm sorry, I didn't know. He goes, that's okay, you stupid beaner. We Latinos, we've had our darker sides. In fact, I was in L.A. during the riots, and it really disgusted me to see people of my color robbing and looting. In fact, the scariest part was that somebody actually took a shot at me, you know, and if it hadn't been for that TV I was carrying, I'd be dead right now. Impersonations occasionally. I found out about a movie that's going to be coming out pretty soon. They were going to make it. It's another sequel, but they offered the guy enough money, and they let him write the script. So get ready next summer for Star Trek VII, The Wrath of Kirk. You guys want to see a scene from this?
Yeah!
Captain, I can't fix a transporter. I can't give you a Warp 5. McCoy smoked all them dilithium crystals.
Damn it, Scotty. Why is it that the only thing on my ship that works is your microwave oven and your refrigerator, you fat bastard? Lieutenant O'Hara is suing me for sexual harassment. It's because I've pulled a gun where no man has gone before. This is McCoy and Captain Kirk at the annual physical. Damn it, Bones, I've been coughing for 30 minutes. Let's get on with the examination. I'll wrap this up with the last impersonation that I do. What would the King of Rock and Roll be doing today if he were still alive? And I want anyone in the audience getting up and saying, boom, boom, boom. Hey, open up, man. It's dark in here. What would he be doing in music if he were still alive? So a little music, please.
In Vegas one time. It's really dark up here. I kicked the shit out of my whole band. I'll be singing karaoke tonight, which, by the way, is Japanese for, where's the band? This is my new album. Hope you like it.
I do.
For the first front guys, first two guys in the front row, stop staring at my ass. Now what? Here we go. Try and keep up. Oh, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. Friends say I'm acting wild as a bug. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Walk through the county jail. There's a bell there, they began to wail. Battle jumping and the jump began to swing. Should have seen this young jailbird sing. Number 47 is at the number 3. You're accused of whatever to see. Should be delighted if you dance with me. Come on through the jailhouse, rock with me. Thank you very much.
Wow, that was great. That was really good. Thank you, King.
It's all right, man.
King.
I like your hair, man.
Now, Alex, what do you have coming up? I mean, what kind of shows do you have going? I can't talk to him this way.
I got a few things going on over there in Memphis. No, actually, do a lot of comedy shows out in Orange County. Keep an eye out in the paper for that. And hopefully soon I'll be on Comedy Compadres, huh?
Yeah! We'd like to thank Alex. He's going to stay here. We're going to show a video from Fredrick's of Hollywood. It's a Valentine's, 3 days away from now, the 14th. So let's go ahead and run that video if we could inside the studio. Alex, why don't you sit back, enjoy this, and me and the King will kick back. And let's put that video up in the booth if we could.
For 48 years, women have flocked to Fredrick's of Hollywood for its famous lingerie. But each February around Valentine's Day, something different happens.
Most of the year, nearly all of our customers are women. But just before Valentine's Day, about 80% of our customers are men. And for many of them, it's the first time that they have ever been inside a lingerie shop.
What is a camisole? I have absolutely no idea.
Tap pants? No idea.
I guess it's just a touchy subject, women's lingerie, just the thought of it.
If a man is slightly intimidated about shopping for his loved one, there is help.
If you're not an expert, don't worry about it. There are lots of styles that come one size fits all. And if you really get stuck and you can't decide what she'll like, pick out something that you'll like, and I'm sure that she'll like it.
It makes a good Valentine's Day gift because it's very sexy and romantic, and it's a very personal gift.
And what is popular this Valentine's Day?
Red is always popular on Valentine's Day. This year we're selling teddies, baby dolls, gowns, chemises, and bodysuits and variations of bodysuits.
And for you men out there...
A camisole is a top, and very often they're worn instead of a blouse. Tap pants go with camisoles, and they're named after the pants that tap dancers wore in the movies of the 1930s. Teddies are about the same shape as a one-piece bathing suit. They're worn under clothes, and when they're very roughly, they're worn as sleepwear.
So, on this Valentine's Day, try something new.
Forget about the candy and forget about the flowers because they're gone. But lingerie can last for a long time and bring pleasure to both you and your man for a long time.
The best part is going home because you really get to enjoy your Valentine's gift.
Wasn't that an enjoyable video?
Woo.
Me and the king are getting hot up here, huh, king?
Pretty hot, man.
Yeah. We'd like to thank Fredericks of Hollywood for sending us that video. So can we hear for Fredericks of Hollywood real quick, folks? Yeah. We're going to go to commercial. And King, why don't you take us out of here?
Don't go away. We'll be right back. Thank you very much.
It's about 5 minutes to airtime. Has anybody seen Marty? Man, that guy's getting such a big head. Where is he?
I'm here, Mirror Mortal. I always wanted to be big in TV. Join me, Marty Shields, on Marty's Corner, Channel 33 Public Access, Friday at 8 o'clock.
Be there.
If you don't, it's all over.
And our next item is Community Access Television, Channel 33. This is local programming not available on any other channel at any price, and we're giving it away free. Just tune in to Channel 33. You're live on Community Access Television. Who's this?
Hi, this is Bobby Puente from Hacienda.
Hi, Bobby. Do you watch Channel 33?
Oh, yes. I watch it all the time. I just love it.
Okay, well, thanks for calling in. Keep on watching Community Access Television, Channel 33. What a great value.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We're back here. We're live for you, Channel 33. And like we said before, when Alex was on, or the king as he likes to be referred to, Valentine's Day is only 3 days away. And myself, I'm married, and it's always so difficult to find the right gift for your loved one, your spouse, your girlfriend, your boyfriend. So what we did was we went around to some of the local shops here in the San Gabriel Valley. Let's go ahead and run that tape on what you can buy for your wife on Valentine's Day. Valentine's Day is only 3 days away, and if you're like me, you wait till the last minute to buy your wife something for Valentine's Day. We're gonna go around today and see what kind of gifts can be gotten at the last minute for all you guys who haven't got anything for your wife.
We have some people here at Conway's who are going to help us out. And what's your name?
Katie.
Katie? Yeah. Katie, and you're the manager here at Conway's?
I'm the night manager, yeah.
The night manager. Valentine's Day seems to be the most popular day for giving of flowers. And I mean, is it really just blown off the roof right now? You got a lot of orders?
Yeah, it's going to get really crazy in here.
Now, I've bought flowers before for my wife, and it seems like every year they get more expensive. Why is that? Why do they get more expensive around February?
Because of the demand for especially red roses, the prices go up a lot. The growers have to make 4 or 5 times as many as during other parts of the year, and it just gets crazy.
How much does it go up during the year? I mean, is there a percentage, or like what's a normal, maybe another normal dozen? What would it go for, and what's it going for now?
It's going to go for $65 a dozen.
$65. I don't think I had that much on me. Do you guys sell like chia pets?
No chia pets.
No chia pets?
We've got dish gardens, but no chia pets.
Chia. Here at Conroy's, they also have Mylar balloons. This one is a special one they have just for this time of the year, and it's from Tanya Harding to Nancy Kerrigan. Hope you're feeling better soon. Thank you, Tanya. Oh, my leg. Oh. Do you have any plastic flowers I can buy?
No plastic flowers. I think we might have one over there that's on the fountain, but that's for our own personal use.
It's a prop?
Yeah, it's a prop.
I got a couple of bucks in my pocket. You know what you don't want to do? One of the hardworking employees here at Conroy's.
We represent the lollipop cares, the lollipop cares, the lollipop cares. We represent the lollipop cares. We cordially invite you to Munchkin Land. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
In our continuing quest to find the perfect Valentine's Day gift for my wife for February 14th, we're now here at Yorgo's in Roland Heights, and we're going to have, what's your name again?
Sophia.
Sophia's going to go ahead and give me a manicure, is that correct?
That's it. This is therapy. This is with reflexology. So you're walking out of here with brand new pair of hands.
Will I feel any better when I'm done?
Definitely.
I have those nice, supple, smooth hands that all the men hope for?
Smooth. It will feel good. It will feel like you've got brand new pair of hands.
Well, let's go for it. Let's take it away. Now, my nails are pretty short as it is.
Nails don't have to be long to have a manicure. Manicuring means taking care of the cuticle.
Oh!
No, it doesn't. It's supposed to be pleasant. It's not supposed to be hurting. Did I dream? This is my dream come true. Maybe someday I'll get discovered.
You never know.
Cut.
Now, what are you putting on me now?
This is avocado oil, which will smoothen and soften your cuticle. Meantime, condition your nail.
Uh-huh.
This is like hair conditioner for hair. This is conditioner for nail and skin.
I'll be all like this. Boy, I just, you know, Sophia, I'm having a heck of a time getting the rust off one of my pumps in my car. Do you have any suggestions what I could use to get the rust off the air pump?
Rust-Oleum.
Rust-Oleum?
Yeah. You should soak your hands in Rust-Oleum.
I would never soak my hands in Rust-Oleum.
You are soaking in it.
Rust-Oleum?
Yes, it's okay.
Is it mild?
It's very mild.
Oh, good. We're now here at See's Candy in Hacienda Heights, and we're here with one of the employees, Lynn. And what's your last name, Lynn?
Wood.
Lynn Wood. And what do you do here exactly at See's Candy?
Sell candy. No, I'm an senior assistant manager.
Valentine's Day is only a week away now, is this your busiest time of the year? I mean, as opposed to Christmas or Mother's Day? Single-handedly, the biggest day?
No, it isn't.
Oh, it's not?
No.
What is the biggest?
Easter is the big, second to Christmas.
I would have thought it would have been Valentine's Day.
It depends on how many men, they wait till the last minute. We pack a hand pack a lot of
candy. You find a lot of gentlemen coming in the last minute and buying things for the ladies?
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything that you actually suggest for them to buy? I mean, do you have any kind of specials or something that you have going that gentlemen can come down? A lot of guys in the audience don't know what to get their wives, and again, last minute shopping is a big thing. Mm-hmm. What kind of things do you have on sale here?
We have our beautiful velvet hearts. Our assortment of velvet hearts, and they're...
What do they go for as far as price range?
In between $10 to $25.
You have like a real...
large heart here that is...
Let's walk this way, John. We're going to walk over here with them. Mm-hmm. And we're going to probably get lost here in the... This is. And how much does that?
Our largest heart.
And how much does that go for?
Four-pound heart for $55.
$55. This gentleman is security here at C's. And what's your name?
Rodney.
Rodney, and you're also an off-duty officer, is that right?
Yes.
What kind of problems do C's have during the year as far as?
Oh, what I'm supposed to do is weigh each employee before they start shift and weigh them at the end to see how much candy they've eaten. No, I'm just kidding.
And do you find that they do have a tendency to pick up a couple pounds?
Yeah, over their time, I'm sure they do. But
do they hire thin people or heavy people here at C's?
They all look like they eat well.
Specific conduct, but it's a caramel with a milk chocolate covering.
Woof. Verbal.
Give me one more before I start wigging out here. My God. And this is toffee covered with a sprinkling of nuts.
Almonds.
Almonds. Mm-hmm.
Oh. What's this? Great.
What time? Excuse me. Man, that is pure chocolate.
Boy.
Isn't that delicious?
That's delicious. So if I buy this for my wife, chances are I'll have a good time on the 14th.
I think so.
We guarantee it. Does she have a guarantee?
Yes. Right.
Olivia, the manager, says we have a guarantee on this.
Quality without compromising.
Quality without compromising.
Do you ever feel that maybe her presence or the feeling of Mary C's around you all the time?
Oh, yes. Always.
Do you feel like it kind of hovers over the store? And
yes, with her candy.
Is that mm-hmm, and yes. She pretty much watches over you?
Watches,
and
yes.
Making sure that Rodney, the security guard, is not not sleeping over there and doing his job?
By weighing us, yes.
Making sure you have the right.
Yeah.
Make sure we're going down to C's. I'll pick me up. Okay, and we'd like to thank C's also for letting us come down here. I said we're gathering things for my wife. I have this beautiful boutonniere from Conroy's, all these beautiful samples from Euros in Roland Heights. And what are you going to give us today, Olivia?
Well, I'd like to present this for your wife.
Oh, beautiful.
C's candy.
C's candy. This is 4 ounces. Thank you so much for letting us come by. Appreciate it so much. Thank you. All right. We got some candy out of this. Cool. Okay. Thank you. On behalf of all the places that allowed us to come in and do this today, we'd like to go out with a clothing song. We represent the Lollipop Kids, the Lollipop Kids, C's Candy Store. Thank you. Happy Valentine's Day. Honey, I love you. Thank you. We'd like to thank everyone who let us come down and do that bit. That was a blast. This time, I'd like to bring on someone who, again, is making his debut here. He's a magician and a great guy. Can you please give a warm welcome to Mr. Bill Perron? Bill, come on out.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now, yes. How'd you get? Oh, look out. There's spirits here because Bill's on. How'd you get into doing this kind of, I mean, where'd it come from, being a magician?
Well, I wish I could say that I was born with a special gift, but I wasn't. I just went to the Magic Castle on a blind date one night and fell in love with magic. And I says, God, that looks like a great lifestyle. These guys can be whatever they want to be. They can tell the biggest lies and travel around the world and get paid to do it. And it just seemed like, to me, like there was no negatives.
Well, what kind of things do you actually do, Bill, as a magician? I mean,
well, sometimes
sleight of hand, yeah. Or what is your forte?
Well, I'll do some sleight of hand. It depends on the occasion. If it's like a banquet or something of that, then they want me to do some strolling magic, where you go from a sleight of hand from person to person, doing little tricks in their hands, cards, coins, whatever. Sometimes I'll do some audience participation comedy magic. Sometimes I'll do some mentalism, where I'll read people's minds, things of that nature there.
Oh, we have a few things here in your bag. Why don't you go ahead and break into that real quick and show us some of the...
You see, number one thing is a magician is a liar. And there's an old saying is that the better the liar, the better the magician.
Okay.
So from here on out, I'm going to be lying to you constantly.
Is that a lie or is that the truth you're telling me?
That's a lie.
Now,
what you see is a little balloon.
Okay, that's what you say that is.
Well, watch what I can do with a little balloon. You will not believe your eyes. You see, right before your very eyes, believe it or not, incredible but true, I took that little balloon and I just made it big. Now I can tell this audience is not easily impressed. So now a magician will do something like, maybe he's going to hypnotize the balloon or some kind of cockamamie thing like that. Naturally, he's not going to do that. But he's going to tell you that he is. And then he's going to tell you he's going to put the needle through the balloon. Now, I'm not going to put this needle through the balloon, but it's going to look like it's going through the balloon. Watch. I will take the needle, push it right here. Now, you see, it looks like it's going through the balloon. In fact, I'm going to make it look like it's coming out the other side. Now, as you can see, it looks like it is. In fact, I can even make it look like the string has gone through the balloon. But I didn't. You see, that's known as an illusion. It's impossible. You can't put needles through balloons.
That was good.
Now, sometimes it's much more impressive when the magic happens in somebody else's hand. Your name again is?
Loree.
That's correct.
You're lying. No.
Loree, you married?
Yes.
Happily?
Yes.
Good. Glad to hear it, Loree.
Work it, Bill.
No, I'm not. Now, Loree, we have three ropes. Probably ropes very similar to those that you and your husband have in your bedroom, right? Would you examine these ropes? See if they will stretch or shrink. You may examine that one, Marty.
Sure,
see if there's any magnets, secret passages, little artesians, communist spies, anything of that nature.
No, I don't see
it. Just plain old ropes.
It looks fine to me, Bill.
Okay. Pain. Now, if you take these three ropes, the illusion is that you're going to take the little rope and put it there, and the medium rope and put it there, and then the long rope and put it there, and then you're going to snap your fingers and make it look like the ropes have all become the same size. Now, of course, we know that that didn't happen, so people will say, well, let's see the ropes one at a time. So then you show them rope number one. If you tug on that rope, see if that rope will stretch or shrink. Okay, that's rope number one, and then here was rope number two. If I pull on rope number two, and then rope number three. In fact, Marty, why don't you pull on all three ropes? Okay, so now the hard part is to make these three ropes become three different sizes in your hands. Would you put your hand out like that? Now I'm going to do this nice and slow. As you can see, there's no sleight of hand, no misdirection. Put these ropes in your hand. Close your hand on top of them tight. Now, I am not even going to touch these ropes anymore. I'm just going to snap my fingers. They've all become three different sizes again in your hand. Slowly pull the end of any rope you want. Keep this hand closed. Slowly pull one rope. Okay. Well, that one didn't change. Try one of the others. Ooh, looks like that one got longer.
Wait a minute, I tied a knot.
Okay. And what have you got left in your hand? So we have one size rope in Loree's hand.
We're running short on time, but we'd like to again thank Bill. Bill, do you want to give me your number real quick if people want to get, you know...
818-579-3697.
He's lying. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here for Bill Perron. We're going to commercial. We'll be right back. Thank you. Good going. Nice to meet you, Bill. I'm sorry. We lost some of the time.
Gosh, it's 5 minutes before airtime. Where's Marty? Has anybody seen Marty? Where's that guy? Jeez.
Hi, Frank. It's me.
Oh,
yeah. I've been so worried about our shrinking ratings, it's really affecting my personality and my disposition.
And your size, too, man.
Oh, man, what am I going to do? Well, I'm going to have to be the stand-in or something.
We just have everybody come up and watch us on Friday night, 8 o'clock.
Please watch me, or I might shrink into oblivion. Help! 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 Okay, welcome to Marty's Corner. Hi, I'm your host, Marty Shields.
Leadoff batter for Highlander B hits a ground ball.
Believing my angel would watch over me.
There's no such thing as killer keys.
Oh! Oh, get out of here!
Hi, how you doing? I'm Kevin the Plumber.
One more time, the corner band, the great Frank, Jim, and Albert, the corner band. At this time, we'd like to go ahead and bring on someone who will just knock your socks off. She's a young singer from Rolling Heights. Is that right, Tamara? Beautiful Rolling Heights. She'll be singing for us here now and another song later. Can you please give a warm welcome to Tamara Wells? Tamara.
Need you here and now.
is all I need. Ooh, 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 ooh. Yeah, 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 yeah. Your love is all I need. Ooh, 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 ooh.
You got a set of pipes. I'm impressed. Tell me about yourself, Tamara. We talked earlier, but tell me something about yourself.
Well, I started singing at an early age, a very early age. I started singing in the church choirs, school choirs. I was in show choir competitions and things like that. I sang in various functions, weddings, receptions, gospel recitals.
So every place would have you, you'd go and do it, huh?
Yes.
What kind of aspirations do you have for your career going? Where is this taking you?
Well, in the near future, I plan to become a professional singer.
Yeah.
I want to become a professional singer or get started in the entertainment field. Just recently, a record company, I guess they heard my tape, and they like what they heard, so now they're going to be writing some material for me. And also, they want me to appear on Star Search.
That's cool. Yeah, a lot of people do start on Star Search.
Yeah.
Could you go and do another song for us? What's the next song you're going to do for us before you leave?
It's Hero.
Hero. Ladies and gentlemen, here again for Carolyn. Carolyn, come on up.
Face the world.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, on a Marty's Corner for a Friday night. Before we leave, we'd like to do something we do here on every show, which is a list of the events going on in our community. Me and Loree will go and read those verbatim right off the air. First one, February is Black History Month. The National Council of Negro Women is sponsoring the annual Black History Program at 3 p.m. Saturday, February 12th at the Lecture Hall 26 at Mount San Antonio College. For more information, please call Dorothy Shepherd at 1-909-595-1141. Loree.
Okay, well, this is not in our community, but this is at Wadsworth Theater in Westwood, just below UCLA. I don't have the address. You can call the theater for times and the address. But I have to give this plug for my hairdresser, Danny, who's appearing in this piece by Rachel Rosenthal. Have you guys heard of Rachel Rosenthal? She's a very bizarre performance artist, and her piece is called Zone, Z-O-N-E, and that is tonight, and tomorrow night is one more performance. Tickets are $23, $19, and $9 for students. And that's Danny is appearing as a throng in this piece.
A throng.
So I'm going to try and see that tomorrow night.
Also,
and you did your hair recently?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Well,
the last one we have is Sonny Bono from Sonny and Cher is going to speak at the San Gabriel Valley chapter of the California Lincoln Club at 7:30 p.m.
Oh, boy.
Get your tickets February 18th at the Ferraro Room, the Industry Hill Sheraton. The cost is $25 per person. Call Natalie at 919-7497. Again, please come back and see us next time on Marty's Corner. And on honor of the Olympics tomorrow, we'd like to have the band go out with Put Me In, Coach. Guys, take it away, and we're out of here. Happy birthday, Jaime! Happy birthday, Jaime!